In an earlier case study where we attempted to create a beaker spout, we had to make a symmetrical spline. It turns out that there is an easier way compared to the method that was shown. These two construction lines will act as a scaffold for the spline. The aim here is to make a spline symmetrical about this center line. Let's first repeat what we did in the previous video. Start a fit point spline. Snap the spline to these three points. Click on the horizontal vertical constraint and set this spline handle to horizontal. In order to make this spline symmetrical about a vertical, we need to mirror the behavior of these two spline handles. Before adding any constraints, gently give each of these spline handles a slight nudge to make them turn blue. Click on the symmetry constraint. Click on the two spline handles, followed by the line of symmetry. If you try to adjust the spline, you will notice that the angle is mirrored, but the length of each spline handle is still independent. To make the spline handles equal in length, let's add an equal constraint. Click on the equal constraint, followed by the two spline handles. The alternative method that I'm going to show here was suggested to me by Mark. A big thank you to Mark for the suggestion. The trick is to add symmetry to the end point of the spline handle instead of the whole handle. Let's start afresh. We have added the horizontal constraint to this spline handle. Again, gently give each of these spline handles a slight nudge to make them turn blue. Click on the symmetry constraint. Notice that as we hover along the spline handle towards the end point turns white. Click to select this point. If you want to be absolutely certain to select the point and not the handle, you can perform a long left click. When the drop-down list appears, select Sketch Point. Lastly, select the center line. If you adjust the handle, you can see that both the angle and the length are mirrored. We do not need to add an equal constraint. There is also no need to add symmetry to this pair of endpoints. This is because the spline handle is already symmetrical about its pivot point. Take note that we could also have chosen to make these two points symmetrical instead. The end result would be the same. Let's dimension the angle and the length of this spline handle. If we try to do the same for the other spline handle, we get a warning that this will over-constrain the sketch, and we can only put down driven dimensions. This proves that the spline handles are indeed symmetrical in both angle and length.